Sometimes we are so busy asking big questions and deconstructing complicated answers that we forget to ask the simple ones too. Often, people take their surroundings at face value with the comfort of familiarity, meaning people forget to ask why things are the way they are. If the sky turned bright yellow tomorrow, we would look up and take notice, wanting an answer as to why. But how many of us know why the sky looks the way it does day to day? Why is it blue? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, why is the sky blue? You may be pleased to know that we do have an answer for you. Before we launch into this video, I just want to ask you guys to hit that thumbs up button if you like our content. Also, why not click on that big and beautiful notification bell if you want to be the first to hear a big answer. So, before we tell you why the sky is blue, I thought we could dispel a few false rumors, some fake news about the reason for our beautiful blue horizon. Some people say the sky is blue because of sunlight reflected off the ocean and back up into the sky. Obviously, that's not the case, as the sky is blue everywhere, not just by the sea. Others say that the sky is blue because of the water in our atmosphere, but again, that isn't true either. The sky is just as blue in dry atmospheres as it is in damper climates. So why then? What makes the sky blue? Well, white light is actually made up of all of the colours of the rainbow: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Each colour that makes up light travel in waves, with red light being the longest wave and blue light being much shorter. Light travels in a straight line, unless it's reflected by a mirror, bent by a prism, or scattered by molecules and gases. Light that reaches the Earth from the Sun is scattered in every direction by the gases and particles that make up our atmosphere. Because of its smaller waves, blue light is far more easily scattered than other colours. The sky is bluest when the sun is high in our line of vision. Those of you who know a thing or two about light waves may be wondering why the sky isn't violet if small waves are the most easily scattered. Red is the biggest light wave, and the waves get smaller as you work the way down the rainbow, leaving violet with the smallest of the bunch. So why isn't the sky purple? Well, that is to do with the human eye, which is much more susceptible to receiving blue light than it is violet light. It's just much easier for us to see. On top of that, a lot of the smaller violet wavelengths are absorbed in high atmospheres. You may wonder why the sky seems more blue directly above you and less blue at the edge of the horizon. Well, this is because of the sunlight reaching us from low in the sky has passed through more air than the sunlight reaching us from overhead. Here, molecules have scattered the blue light, then scattered them all over again in many different directions. On top of that, the surface of the Earth also works to absorb, reflect, and scatter more light, making it appear more white at the edge of the horizon. Of course, the sky isn't always blue. At night it's black. No prizes for guessing why that is, but why is the sky red and orange when the sun is setting? That is because the light is passing through more of the atmosphere to reach your eyes. On top of that, localized particles like dust, pollution, or salt scatter away the blue light further. Both of these things mean that your eyes pick up red and yellow light early in the morning or late in the day. One example, have you ever noticed that a sunset appears more vivid over the ocean? This is because of the increased salt particles in the air. A fun fact, then a question to round off this video. The fun fact is that the sky on Mars would also appear blue because our neighbor has a similar atmosphere to us. Now, the Viking Mars landers in the 70s showed the Martian sky as red, but this was only because the image taken happened to be during one of Mars's sandstorms. And a question to leave you musing on until the next video. While we all agree that the sky is blue during the day, how do we know that we all see the same color as blue? So this video answered a nice simple question for you, so why don't you leave us a nice simple thumbs up as a big thank you. Also, do you feel free to subscribe for more daily big answers. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. There are links to my social media in the description box down below if you want to connect with me. I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.